In a bold move that is reshaping the dynamics of military power in the Mediterranean region, the United States has authorized the transfer of 35 UH-60 Black Hawk helicopters and additional military equipment to Greece. This monumental deal, totaling a staggering $1.95 billion, comes at a time when Greece's arch-rival Turkey is seeking F-16 fighter jets from Washington. The U.S. Defense Security Cooperation Agency, or DSCA, made the official announcement on December 15th, unveiling the comprehensive agreement. Included in this package are the UH-60 M-type Black Hawk helicopters, alongside an arsenal of military armaments that range from miniguns and machine guns to advanced electronic suits. Lockheed Martin's subsidiary, Sikorsky, is set to take the lead as the principal contractor for this colossal endeavor. This development marks a significant turning point in Greece's commitment to strengthening its defense capabilities. Earlier this year, Greek Defense Minister Nikos Dendias unveiled an ambitious plan to increase defense spending by approximately $12.62 billion over the next 4 years. This plan includes a comprehensive set of 19 significant procurements, such as the upgrade of 37 F-16 Block 50 aircraft and the acquisition of at least 20 F-35 fighter jets. In January 2021, Greece inked a landmark agreement with the renowned French aerospace giant Dassault Aviation for the purchase of 18 Rafale fighter jets. Yet, the Greek commitment to bolstering its air power did not stop there. In March 2022, another deal was signed, bringing the total number of Rafale fighter jets to an impressive 24. Moreover, Athens has formally requested the United States for the procurement of 20 F-35 fifth-generation stealth fighter jets, demonstrating their unwavering dedication to modernizing their military capabilities. Greek Prime Minister Kyriakos Mitsotakis made it abundantly clear during a NATO summit in June 2022 that they are determined to acquire an entire F-35 squadron, with the possibility of a second one in the pipeline. The U.S. Senator Bob Menendez, who chairs the Senate Committee on Foreign Relations, provided the green light for the sale of Lockheed Martin's F-35 fighter jets to Greece, marking a pivotal moment in Greek military modernization. The pace of Greek military modernization has never been more rapid. In addition to the aforementioned acquisitions, plans are in motion to enhance the capabilities of the Greek armed forces further. This includes the acquisition of 3 FDI-type frigates, a total of 83 additional F-16 fighter modifications, and the approval for the purchase of Israeli-made Spike NLOS missile systems. Greece's commitment to strengthening its military forces is not just a national endeavor, it is a NATO alliance in action. Greece consistently allocates more than 2% of its GDP to defense, displaying an unwavering dedication to the collective security of NATO. However, tensions with another NATO ally, Turkey, have cast a shadow over the region for many years. The long-standing disputes between Greece and Turkey span several issues, including disputes over energy resources, the ethnically divided island of Cyprus, overflights in the Aegean Sea, and the delineation of continental shelves and maritime boundaries. These tensions have been a source of concern within the NATO alliance. However, there is a glimmer of hope on the horizon. On December 14, a historic meeting took place between Turkish President Tayyip Erdogan and Greek President Sofia, signaling a significant shift in their relations. They pledged to increase trade, resolve outstanding issues, particularly in the Aegean Sea, foster good neighborly relations, and pursue military confidence-building measures to reduce tensions. Just one day later, the United States announced its approval for the transfer of UH-60 Black Hawk helicopters and military equipment to Greece. This decision underscores Greece's unwavering commitment to military modernization, even in the midst of thawing tensions with Ankara. However, there's a twist to this story. While Greece continues to bolster its air power with acquisitions from NATO allies like France and the United States, Turkey finds itself in a precarious situation. Ankara has been pleading for F-16 fighter jets and Eurofighter Typhoons, but the road to obtaining them has been fraught with challenges. Turkey's plea for F-16 fighter jets is urgent and strategic, following its expulsion from the F-35 development program over the purchase of Russian S-400 fighter jets. Ankara has been attempting to purchase 40 F-16 airplanes and 80 F-16 modification kits to replace its aging fleet. The aging F-16s need an urgent upgrade, especially since the F-35s are elusive and Turkey's next-generation fighter currently under development will not be ready for deployment for several years. An urgent purchase has become imperative to combat its rival Greece's technologically advanced fighter fleet. In July this year, U.S. President Joe Biden's administration backed Turkey's desire to purchase 40 new Lockheed Martin Corporation F-16 fighter jets and modernization kits for its existing warplanes from the U.S. However, the deal needs approval from U.S. Congress, which is not forthcoming. Yasar Guler, the Minister of National Defense, stated that technical meetings about the F-16 procurement have concluded and emphasized that Turkey anticipates positive and solid steps from the United States. "We expect the process to start with positive and concrete steps as soon as possible," Guler informed reporters during a year-end assessment conference in Ankara, the capital of Turkey. Upset by the U.S. Congress sitting on the decision to supply F-16s, Turkey began talks with European states on buying the most advanced variant of the 40 Eurofighter Typhoon. It has been talking with the consortium that builds the fighter jet, including the UK, Spain, and Germany. However, the talks have hit roadblocks with German disapproval of the sale. Guler noted that sanctions are the primary concern in the procurement process. He consistently states that allies should understand Turkey's global and regional function well and consequently immediately give up such restriction practices. "We emphasize that a strong Turkey and a strong Turkish Armed Forces, TSK, mean a strong NATO and a strong alliance and a strong fight against terrorism," he noted. He further noted that Turkey believes that Eurofighter jets are the best option. He stated that Turkey intends to buy 40 Eurofighters, 20 of which will be the first generation and 20 of which will be the upgraded model. Germany has come under fire from Ankara several times for turning down its desire to purchase the planes. According to Guler, they anticipate a German reaction that upholds the spirit of NATO alliance. "The UK's support and approach on this issue are important as it sets an example for other allies. Spain also provides similar support to us. Regarding Germany's objections, it would be the right approach to take options and decisions in line with the common security perspective based on the spirit of alliance," the minister noted. With NATO allies, US and Germany, dithering on the sale of fighter jets that Turkey desperately needs, there is speculation that Ankara could turn towards their rivals Russia and China for its requirement.